APCO Infratech, one of the fastest growing mid-sized infrastructure companies with its corporate office in Gurugram, Haryana, is a leading player in the fields of highways, energy, tunnel, irrigation, urban infrastructure and industrial development sector. The company is recognized for its endeavors in the tunnel infrastructure and has undertaken many ambitious projects like the construction of the 6.5 kilometer tunnel in Jammu and Kashmir. The company has recently bagged big tunneling projects from RVNL at Rishikesh. When it comes to selecting equipment for tunneling, Sandvik has always been APCO's first choice, even for the upcoming Rishikesh project, one of the longest tunnels in the country. From Rishikesh to Karnaprayag, APCO has chosen Sandvik's latest DT922i tunneling jumbo after due diligence and extensive research on available options in the market within this category.
Our experience with Sandvik dates back to the Zedmore project, where we have procured three machines of Sandvik tunneling along with the breakers over there. Then similarly, continuing the same experience and expertise, we have taken DT922A, which is requiring the contract specification. That's an automatic boomer which has got 21 meter auto rod handling system, as well as the entire computerized drilling patterns which can generate. So the relation is still going on, and I hope it will be going continuing further also.
This is our first machine in India. We are launching that machine in 922i at that site. We are using the iShore and also GeoShore in DT922i.
In tunneling, the important machine is drilling jumbo, and without the drilling jumbo, this tunneling is not possible as we foresee. So conventionally in India, manual jumbos have been used till date, and in those jumbos there is a lack of record keeping, and we are not able to get any drill pattern execution record from the machine. And this is where your machine, Sandvik's DT922i machine, helps us, where we have the pattern which was executed before taking a blast.
Still, we are to know much more into the machine, what it is going to give. But ultimately, we are finding it since many advanced features are there.
The DT922i tunneling jumbo from Sandvik is fully automated, offering best-in-class safety and productivity. DT922i is powered by Sandvik's patented intelligent underground rock excavation software, iShore.
We have done a long hole drilling of 21 meter with the machine because it has got automatic rod handling. Then we are seeing the phase drillings, which are pretty fast, and we are able to know from the reports how much is our time it is taking for each drill pattern, other things.
Here with this machine, the biggest benefit is that only one operator is sufficient to operate both the booms. The jumbo is loaded with the rod handlers, so you don't require any person standing on the basket to load additional rods in case you want to have deep hole drillings behind the face. In that sense, the entire operation is fully automated, and the drilling time has reduced from 5+ hours to just under 3 hours. So it has helped us to save at least 2.5 hours in the cycle time for drilling of the face.
With iShore, which is Sandvik patented, even the most tedious tasks like planning the tunnel line from the end of the hole, assessing the geological aspect and conditions of the rock, equipment navigation, face drilling plans, bolting plan or boom drilling sequence are almost automated. The DT922i also generates various critical reports on drilling operation, efficiency and utilization of rig, drilling parameters, in order to assess the blasting vibration and pullout analysis. The machine's MWD, or Measure While Drilling feature, measures 19 different drilling parameters encountered by various rock conditions in real time. And that's not all. With its GeoShore system on this machine, the operator can estimate the rock property to take preventive action for the next cycle if required. To ensure complete safety for the operator, the DT922i is equipped with soundproof next generation iCab operator cabin with ROPS, rollover protection, and FOPS, fall over protection certification.
DT922i, we can get that anti-collision system in this machine. This can measure everything, that we are, the booms never collide, better comfortableness for the operator also. He can see the errors also.
Sandvik understands the local implications and requirements of operations for its customers and is determined to respond to their needs quickly and effectively.
The after-sales support is pretty good now, especially for the project. Wherever we have got certain doubts, it's getting clarified. Since this being the new machine, still people need to are getting also trained, and Sandvik is also taking interest in training them by sending it to Finland and all other places, so that the performance at the site will become absolutely right. Initially, we were skeptical, then we started, why not, let's give a try with this particular alpha rods and alpha bits, which are specifically made for this one. Then we started drilling and comparing with our earlier drill rods and drill bits. And on an overall, we are what the data from the site, what I have received or reviewed, it revealed that it is giving me a higher life of almost around 20% with when compared with the original drill bit system.
The DT922i is extremely maintenance friendly and has a unique design of having a very small number of hydraulic hoses that minimizes the oil spillage to environment. The company has earned the trust and loyalty of its customers by providing 24/7 service, genuine parts, rock tool support at their doorstep.
Customer is happy with the safety concern features of this machine.
Sandvik's untiring efforts towards continuous improvement with a highly motivated workforce have enabled us to create a winning partnership with APCO Infra Limited for over a decade. APCO and Sandvik are proud to share that the Adit 2 of this RVNL project was completed 1 month ahead of the scheduled time using this fully automatic drill machine DT922i, which is a significant achievement towards sustainability